Firefighters and other first responders are taking additional precautions to protect themselves and others against the spread of coronavirus. CBS 4's Zach Myers has more on the extra steps they're taking tonight.
Well, because of what they do, firefighters and emergency medics are at much greater risk of catching coronavirus than most people. So in the midst of this pandemic, they're adjusting to a new normal.
As Bargersville firefighters respond to a call about a person injured in their home, emergency dispatchers are already asking questions over the phone about the person they're rushing to help.
Dispatchers will actually obtain if they have any flu-like symptoms. And they ask them if they've had any type of fever, if they've traveled recently.
In this case, the answer was no.
So by the time we got here, we already knew that the patient had negative screenings for any type of COVID-19.
A couple hours later, a call about a sick person with flu-like symptoms prompted medics to put on extra protective gear just in case the person has COVID-19. It's something departments around the nation are getting used to.
The less exposure to our folks that we can put on them is best, because we want to make sure we keep our folks in service so there are people here to respond.
The concern comes as 10 members of the White River Township Fire Department are still in isolation after coming in contact with a potential coronavirus patient. Bargersville Deputy Fire Chief Michael Pruitt says protective gear is just one part of the new protocol. Departments are also starting to designate some ambulances for one purpose, transporting patients that may have COVID-19.
I'd say we're probably around 6 calls now in the past week. Where we've had to transport someone that potentially may have had the virus.
This ambulance has very little equipment inside it to make it faster and easier to decontaminate if it's used to transport someone who may have the virus. Not only are the new measures designed to protect responders,
we're also making sure that the people that we respond on are getting the service they need, and also that we're not, you know, taking anything to them.
These policies and protocols are evolving as departments are constantly getting new guidance from health officials. There's no telling how long they'll be necessary. Reporting in Johnson County, Zach Myers, CBS 4 News.